Hey everybody, thank you for dropping into DeFi Divvy. My name is Matthew, welcome and glad you are here. On this channel, we like to talk about simple crypto passive income strategies that are implemented on blockchains with utility, use cases, and that solve business problems. If you like that type of content, subscribe here or follow me right down here at DeFi Divvy on Twitter. As always, none of this is investment advice. I am not an investment advisor. Always do your own research outside of this channel. Okay, let's get into it. Exciting news coming down my Twitter feed today. Tweet out by Hedera, and I quote, "We are excited to announce that Dell has joined the Hedera Governing Council, helping organizations explore distributed ledger technology and developing applications for highly decentralized mission-critical environments such as edge computing at Dell Edge." In the second part of the thread, number two, and I quote, "Since its inception almost 40 years ago, Dell has maintained its position as a global leader in computing by joining the Hedera Governing Council. Dell will further strengthen its ability to help customers on their digital transformation through the application of distributed ledger technology." Yeah, 40 years ago. Remember those Dell commercials from 40 years ago? Dude, you got a Dell? No, never mind. Caffeine. And I quote the third part, "We look forward to seeing the value this new partnership will bring with Dell's unique insights and extensive industry experience to the Hedera ecosystem and Web3 as a whole, further accelerating the global shift towards a decentralized future." This piece of news was also covered by The Block, and I quote, "Technology giant Dell will join the likes of Google, FIS, and other governing councils and other members of the governing council of the enterprise network Hedera, a distributed ledger technology that uses hashgraph consensus mechanism." And I quote, "Now you are seeing a whole industry start to grow. Lots of investment," said David Futura, Senior Director of Technology Strategy at Dell. And I quote, "And for us, it becomes more and more serious for us to pay attention and focus on this." That's right, Dell. Dell is realizing it's time to start focusing on distributed ledger technology, on blockchain technology, because it solves problems for business. And it's actually a bad business decision to ignore it, because ultimately businesses want to make more money. And by using this technology, you remove lots of intermediaries and your margins just grow a lot larger. So that is so cool. They are starting to see the light. Dell next. And I quote, "As part of the governing council, Dell will run a consensus node, which is used to determine transaction ordering. Members of the governing council also manage the software related to the network." So that's cool. They're going to run a node, meaning you, me, probably right through our Hashpack wallets, can delegate or stake directly on a Dell node. I wonder if it's up already. I could check today. Although right now I'm doing really well staking on an LG node. And it's coming in at like 6% APR. I'll take it. You know, collect my rewards every couple of days. I'll take free HBAR any day. And after this news, I just, you know, if we have a little downturn, I hope I'm smart enough to buy more HBAR. I've been dollar cost averaging in for a while. I know I've said that in other videos. So I'm happy, but I always want more. I always want more HBAR. I don't think that's ever going to stop. This thing's just really cool. Okay, let's move on. And I quote, "Dell also intends to leverage the Hedera network within applications, but that's still early days. As far as any use case, I think it's a little premature," Futura said. "As we get our steam rolling, maybe later this year, we'll see some more, but not right now. Let's just get on the council." Yeah, and there's lots of use cases for this thing. I mean, you know, distributed ledger technology, single source of truth can be used. It's really for business problems it's solving now. It's solving problems with healthcare, which desperately needs a single source of truth. It's all, you know, the records are fragmented. It's quite a struggle. I've just dealt with that recently with the loss of a parent. Just kind of you move a parent from one medical facility to another. And sometimes it feels like you're practically starting over with all the information instead of having a single source of truth. So this is great. Another use case, supply chain. And I could see, could you see Dell using this in supply chain applications? Edge computing they mentioned. I wonder what they're thinking there. That sounds interesting. Okay, so let's talk about what this means for adoption by the general populace, by you and me. If you look at the governing council of Hedera, you can see Dell on there now, posted up here with other giants, Google, IBM, LG, Boeing, Avery Dennison, Dentons, Deutsche Telekom, ServiceNow, the big, gigantic corporations, entities. Each one of these are running nodes. It's safe to assume these entities running nodes are probably building applications as well. What does that mean for adoption? To me, what I believe that means is that you, me, people who aren't in crypto, your grandma and grandpa, your kids, your brothers and sisters who could care less, they're all going to be using HBAR and they won't even know it because it'll just happen under the hood when they book a flight or when they are checked into a hospital or when they buy a bottle of wine from the liquor store, when they buy an Italian scarf. They'll be paying in fiat, and then under the hood, that fiat will, portion of it will probably be converted into HBAR for the applications that are being used powering the Hedera ledger, or built on top of the Hedera ledger, I should say. So when you have all that activity happening under the hood, you have tons of transactions happening, and transaction fees, which are super, super cheap on Hedera, are still going to add up to be able to incentivize people like you and me to continue staking. As Hedera starts to go permissionless, it's going to incentivize people to spin up their own nodes. One day you and I will be able to spin up nodes just like Google and IBM and Dell are able to. So right now this is permissioned, but it will go permissionless. That's the intention. So all these transaction fees instead of inflation is what will keep the thing afloat and keep the rewards, the return on investment for staking coming in, and make it worthwhile for devs and startups to build apps on top of this thing, including the giants who are already building apps on top of this thing. I'm so glad I started researching this project. Well, it was during a bull market, but I'm glad I started researching it then, and then I was able to catch a good buying opportunity during the bear market of 2022, and I think a lot of people say we might be coming out of that bear market now. Hindsight will let us know for sure, but I'm excited. I hope you are too. Exciting stuff. Okay, everybody, I'm going to wrap this one up, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.